Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. Today is going to be an exciting freaking day because I have another book haul for you guys. I know it has been quite some time since my last haul, but I am bringing you another one and I have 8 books to show you. Technically I had 9, but with my weekend reading vlog, it was Crave. And we all know Crave is a vampire paranormal romance with Grace and Jackson. And I feel like I talked a lot about it in my weekend vlog, so I'm not really gonna share it with you guys in this video, but just know that I had also bought it at the same time or around the same time when I bought these. So I am super excited to show you these. Without further ado, let's get into the video. Are you ready, guys? Because in my hand is book number 1, and that is Claire McIntosh's Hostage. Now, this is a new release. Clearly, I got it from Target. I hate these stickers so much, you guys. They leave markings on these books, and dog hair gets on it, and I just can't stand it. I hate that the stickers are on here, but at the same time, I don't like the way the book looks after the sticker is off. So this is quite a dilemma, but anyways, nonetheless, this book, okay, so I've never read anything by this author before, so this is technically going to be my very first read from her, so I'm super excited. Now, this, as we can clearly tell by the way this cover looks, this is going to be a thriller, a suspense, a psychological type of novel. And to be quite honest, the reason why I picked this one up is because of the cover. So I was kind of intrigued because this looks really gloomy. First of all, there are 2 houses, one with the light in the window, and then we have a plane. And as soon as I saw the plane and hostage, I was like, okay, this has to be one of those plane hostage situations. And I've never read anything like that. I have seen a couple, you know, like, I don't know, reruns as maybe Law and Order or some CSI, NCIS, something like that, where there was probably a plane hostage, but this is the first time I'm ever actually going to read about one. Now, in this book, I'm gonna kind of read you the synopsis. So it says, despite the buzz in the air, the inaugural nonstop flight between London and Sydney is just another day for flight attendant Mina, a way to put some distance between herself and the secrets that are devastating her marriage and burdening her already troubled 5-year-old daughter. Until she gets the note, the following instructions will save your daughter's life. In the claustrophobic cabin of the jet, Mina is suddenly aware of the hundreds of strangers surrounding her. Any one of them could be behind the threat. No matter what choice she makes next, someone on her plane wants to ensure it never reaches its destination. There are 20 hours between London and Sydney. 20 hours to make an impossible choice for everyone on board. With hundreds of lives in your hands, could you sacrifice the one you loved most? Wow, you guys. That synopsis just like blew me away when I had read that in Target. I immediately just put it in my cart because I've just never, I don't know how I'm going to feel when I read about this. I feel like I'm just going to be on the edge of my seat reading this because what do you do in this situation when you have a loved one, especially your offspring, a daughter or a son, and then you're also in charge of hundreds of people, but they're all strangers to you. So what do you choose? And it's kind of going back to that whole scenario where you're like on the train tracks, whether you run over like a couple of people or just like one person. And it's always hard to make that decision. So I'm really excited to see how the flight attendant kind of makes her decision, how she strategizes, how she maps. Maybe she can save everyone, including her daughter. Maybe she can't, I don't know. But this is definitely going to be a very intense reading. And I'm super excited to start this. So definitely gonna be probably on my September TBR for sure. It's really high up there. So go check it out, guys. Book number 2 is that of That Summer by Jennifer Weiner. This is what happens. I don't even know if you can see it because it's all white. I had taken the Target sticker off and it's so sticky and it left like an ugly residue and I'm so freaking annoyed with myself for doing that. But anyways, so I picked up this book about a couple of weeks ago. I had never heard of it. It kind of just intrigued me based off the cover. I thought the cover was absolutely stunning and I I really adored it. And really and truly, I was kind of curious as to why both women, first of all, they're not facing you. So it makes it even more mysterious as to why they're facing the opposite direction and why they're looking at a very small, I don't know if you can see that, small shack of a house by either a beach or a lake of some sort. And so that really intrigued me. Jennifer Weiner's also going to be a new author that I'm going to read. And just to give you a little bit of background from Goodreads. Goodreads is saying that the genre, obviously it's fiction, but they're saying this is chick lit, it's contemporary, and it's also kind of mystery romance. I definitely didn't get romance from this cover. If anything, I got more mystery. We'll see how this goes. It is a pretty long read, or at least to me it is. It is 432 pages for the hardcover. It's kind of a long novel-ish. I mean, it is very thick. I do like the feel though of this like matte cover instead of, I don't know, like the glossy hardcovers that sometimes I get. This is what it looks like, you guys. Super stoked. So the synopsis, we are following two main characters. So we have Daisy Shoemaker. It says Daisy Shoemaker can't sleep with a thriving cooking business, full schedule volunteer work, and a beautiful home in the Philadelphia suburbs. She should be content. But her teenage daughter is rebelling, her husband can be distant, her work can be trivial, and she's lost the only real friend she's actually ever had. Still, Daisy knows that she's got a good, so why is this keeping her up? As Daisy starts receiving misdirected emails, meant for a woman named Diana Starling, whose address is just one punctuation mark off, she imagines a more glamorous single lady life, miles away from her own. While Daisy's driving carpools, Diana is traveling the world. While Daisy's making dinner, Diana's making plans to reorganize corporations. An apology leads to an invitation, and the two women meet and become friends. But as they get closer, we learn that their connection was not completely accidental. Who is Diana, and what does she want with Daisy? From the manicured main line of Philadelphia to the wild beaches of the Outer Cape, Jennifer Weiner's vibrant wit and brilliant observations bring to life the story of two strangers who find they can only move forward with their lives by confronting their shared past. That sounds absolutely adoring, and I don't know, I'm just really intrigued to see what, if any, connection there is. I mean, people are saying that this is a romance, so I'm kind of interested to see if maybe the husband is involved in some sort of way. I mean, I'm just putting it out there. This might be one of those infidelity books, just because it's weird. Well, okay, it's not weird. I'm just doing context clues, you guys. But I mean, Jennifer Weiner did say that Daisy's husband can be distant, and there's obviously something connecting them in their past. So I don't know. I'm just kind of putting my two cents out there, saying that it's probably the husband that's connecting them. But I'm super like wanting to nosedive and be really fishy and have my investigation cap on and just kind of go on this journey with Jennifer and see what happens to Daisy. I feel like we're gonna fall in love with Daisy and we're gonna be really sus with Diana. I don't know. I get that vibe. But nonetheless, guys, this is also a new book from 2021. Highly recommend it if you're looking for contemporary, on, in my opinion, mystery. But I'm sure there's some type of weird romance going on in here. If you're interested in that, go pick this up. Up next, we have book number three, and that is The Maidens by Alex Michaelides. I apologize if I am mispronouncing his last name. Please, someone in the comments, correct me if I am wrong. Also, disregard stupid Target sticker. I don't know why this is such an annoying pet peeve of mine, but I'm gonna cover it for the time being. First of all, you guys, the cover is absolutely stunning. This is a work of art, quite literally. That is the whole reason and sole purpose I picked up this book in the first place at Target, was because of this cover, primarily this region. I don't know why my eyes were gravitated towards that part and I picked it up and went for it. This book came out June 15th of this year, I believe. It's only 337 pages, so it's not too long of a read, I would say, just kind of in the middle. Now with this, now this is a psychological bent. This is a murder slash crime novel. Definitely something to keep in mind if you're wanting to read this, that there's probably some murder in here and who knows what else that tags along with this type of book. The synopsis says, Edward Fosca is a murderer. Of this, Mariana is certain, but Fosca is untouchable, a handsome and charismatic Greek tragedy professor at Cambridge University. Fosca is adored by staff and students alike, particularly by the members of a secret society of female students known as the Maiden. Mariana Andros is a brilliant but troubled group therapist who becomes fixated on the Maidens when one member, a friend of Mariana's niece Zoe, is found murdered in Cambridge. Mariana, who was once herself a student at the university, quickly suspects that behind the idyllic beauty of the spires and turret and beneath the ancient traditions lies something sinister. And she becomes convinced that, despite his alibi, Edward Fosca is guilty of the murder. But why would the professor target one of his students? And why does he keep returning to the rites of Persephone, the Maiden, in her journey to the underworld? When another body is found, Mariana's obsession with proving Fosca's guilt spirals out of control, threatening to destroy her credibility as well as her closest relationship. Mariana is determined to stop this killer, even if it costs her everything, including her own life. That sounds amazing, you guys. Absolutely amazing. I am really intrigued to see how Mariana kind of hopefully put everything together and solves all of these gruesome murders by Edward, if it is in fact Edward. And I'm really curious to see how we're gonna have Greek mythology kind of incorporated with this. I'm assuming there's going to be some type of connection between Persephone and the underworld and how she even got there in the first place and kind of linking the murders. That is what I am thinking about when I first picked up this novel. That kind of just ran in my head very quickly, which made me interested in picking up this. I typically don't gravitate towards Greek mythology. Nothing weird with Greek mythology. I do have Circe and I do have the Song of Achilles, so I have not read them yet. I think this maybe will pull me into the Greek mythology world just a little bit with a contemporary literature or novel. We shall see how that goes. But if you're interested in something as diabolical as what I think this book is going to be about, definitely pick it up. Book number four is a book that I am super, super stoked to read. This is definitely going to be on my September TBR list, and that is Rabbits by Terry Miles. I know that this book isn't as popular on Goodreads. It just came out. Maybe not a lot of people know about it, which is why I'm so excited to talk to you guys about it. I know for like 1000% of a fact that I'm going to have a very personal connection with this book. And the reason being is because Terry Miles, he just has such a brilliant mind. So he created several podcasts that I just absolutely adore. And to be quite honest, he's the reason why I love podcasts. I first heard of him, I think in 2016 or 2017, when I discovered The Black Tapes and Tannis. I believe those were the two that were out at the time. He also has done The Last Movie and of course Rabbit. And I don't know, like his mind is just so brilliant. Like the way he maps out a podcast story, he just keeps you at the edge of your seat. Like you keep wanting more. And I am so excited because I know he is currently working, I think, on season 6 of Tannis. He's currently working on another season of Rabbit. And I even think The Last Movie is still in production. All of that, I mean, that just in and of itself has made me so excited. But the fact that he released a freaking book about rabbits, I am just going to give you the synopsis of what Rabbits even is. And I'm hoping you can just dive into the world with me, because Terry Miles just absolutely nails it when it comes to like paranormal and sci-fi related podcasting. So I can only imagine what he's written on paper, you guys. This is the synopsis. It's an average work day. You've been wrapped up in a task and you check the clock when you come up for air, 4:44 p.m. You check your email and 44 unread messages have built up. With the shock, you realize the date is April 4th, 4:44. And when you get in your car to drive home, your odometer reads 44,444. Coincidence? Or have you just seen the edge of a rabbit hole? Rabbits is a mysterious alternate reality game, so vast it uses the entire world as its canvas. Since the game started in 1959, 10 iterations have appeared and 9 winners have been declared. The identity of these winners are unknown. So is their reward, which is whispered to be NSA or CIA recruitment, vast wealth, immortality, or perhaps even the key to the secrets of the universe itself. But the deeper you get, the more dangerous the game becomes. Players have died in the past, and the body count is rising, and the 11th round is about to begin. Enter Kay, a rabbit's obsessive who has been trying to find a way into the game for years. The path opens when Kay is approached by billionaire Alan Scarpio, rumored to be the winner of the 6th iteration. Scarpio says that something has gone wrong with the game, and that Kay needs to fix it before 11 start, or the whole world will pay the price. 5 days later, Scarpio is declared missing. 2 weeks after that, Kay blows the deadline. 11 begins, and suddenly, the fate of the entire universe is at stake. Oh my gosh, you guys, I'm so ready to get pulled back into the universe of Rabbit. When I first heard the podcast, so it is the same kind of thing. We are talking about rabbits. We are talking about the game. Podcasting just followed, I think, a couple of other different characters. And like I said, he's still working on that podcast. But the fact that I get a book with a beginning, middle, and end, and I can just read it in one go, just makes me so freaking excited, you guys. So if you're interested in kind of the alternate reality, suspense, definitely suspense. Highly, highly suggest you pick up Terry Miles' Rabbits. And let me know, if you do, please let me know what your thoughts are in the comments, because I'm dying to meet other diehard Terry Miles fans. So I'm definitely one of them. Up next, we have book number 5. And that is A Master of Zen by P. Jelly Clark. This book came out this year in May, and I've had my eye on this book since March or April of this year. So not too long before this book came out. And the main reason was because it was heavily promoted on my social media platforms. And the cover, you guys, absolutely stunning. Just got to me. So I'm gonna like immediately dive into what this cover looks like. So we have a palace of some sort. We have a main character going up the stairs in the middle. And then up here, we have just beautiful machinery, which this really captivated me. I knew that this was going to be a fantasy of some sort, but what I didn't realize is that it's a historical fiction fantasy with a steampunk world, which is why we have all this machinery up here. I'm super excited about that. For one, because I've never really read anything with steampunk in it. I know that's a very popular theme in a book. I've just never personally had anything that I sort of liked with steampunk. I do like sci-fi, but I know sci-fi typically has steampunk in it, and I've just never really found anything fascinating. So this is going to be one of my very first reads with a huge steampunk influence. So I'm super excited to start this. It is a historical fiction. We're set in Cairo. It's 1912. It says, though Fatma el-Sha'rawi is the youngest woman working for the Ministry of Alchemy, Enchantments, and Supernatural Entities, she's certainly not a rookie, especially after preventing the destruction of the universe last summer. So when someone murders the members of a secret brotherhood dedicated to one of the most famous men in history, Al-Jahiz, Agent Fatma is called to the case. Al-Jahiz transformed the world 40 years ago when he opened up the veil between the magical and mundane realms before vanishing into the unknown. This murderer claims to be Al-Jahiz, returning to condemn the modern age for its social oppression. His dangerous magical abilities instigate unrest in the streets of Cairo that threatens to spill onto the global stage. Alongside her ministry colleagues and a familiar face from the past, Agent Fatma must unravel the mystery behind this imposter to restore peace to the city, or face the possibility he could be exactly who he seems. Wow, that sounds kind of terrifying, to be honest. Imagine someone coming who has been this like world leader who did something as crazy as find another realm, another universe that has magic, and you all kind of celebrate him, and you probably have all of these festivals and festivities just around his name, and then he may be the person who comes back and basically condemns the world to an oblivion of hell. That sounds honestly terrifying, but it's exciting, and I can't wait to read this book. That sounded so weird when I said that, but I think that this is going to be a very interesting read. To me, honestly, this seems like historical fiction, yes, but more along the lines of a mystery fantasy. No, I can't even put those words together, you guys. Which I've never really, I mean, fantasies typically have, you know, somewhat of a mystery, but I think this is going to be my first like detective mystery novel set in a fantasy world where there's magic and there's steampunk. I mean, what more could you want in a book, especially a book that's this stunning? I mean, just let me know. Literally, in the comments, let me know, what do you think about this book? Have you read it? I mean, don't tell me too many things. Don't tell me spoilers, because I do want to read this sometime soon, possibly in September, who knows. I feel like this is definitely a fall, winter book. I just get those vibes from it. So we'll see. Up next is book number 6, and that is Rhapsodic by Laura Talassa. So this is a paranormal romance, and I'm not even gonna lie, I picked this up off of the book talk table at Barnes & Noble. I have seen this all throughout book talk and I didn't really think much about it. I mean, I saw the book and I didn't save it or anything like that. But then when I went to the book talk table at Barnes & Noble, they just had so many things. Paranormal romances, just a lot of smut content at this one particular table. And this was on there. And so I kind of picked it up. One, I was very intrigued by the actual book itself. So that looks like it is a wing. It looks like a bat wing, but I don't think that's what that is. And then there's some type of clothing or cloth that just kind of draped on the top of it. So I picked this up because of book talk. Yes, the book talk table. I don't know why I feel so embarrassed saying that, because I definitely wanted to get into book talk. I don't know, maybe it's the smut book talk that's kind of embarrassing. Like when I was at that table, I was like, I felt like I was like at an adult store looking at these types of books. But you know, I still bought it anyways, so I wasn't that embarrassed. But nonetheless, I think this is going to be a fantastic, spicy book that I have no doubt is just going to stay in my mind. So this is a Greek mythology, I would honestly say, because it deals with sirens. The synopsis for Rhapsodic says, Calypso Lilis is a siren with a very big problem, one that stretches up her arm and far into her path. For the last several years, she's been collecting a bracelet of black beads up her wrist, magical IOUs for favors she's received. Only death or repayment will fulfill the obligation. Only then will the beads disappear. Everyone knows that if you need a favor, you go to the bargain to make it happen. He's a man who can get you anything you want at a price. And everyone knows that sooner or later he always collects. But for one of his clients, he's never asked for repayment. Not until now. When Callie finds the Fae King of the Night in her room, a grin on his lips and a twinkle in his eye, she knows things are about to change. At first, it's just a chaste kiss, single beads worth, and a promise for more. For the bargainer, it's more than just a matter of rekindling an old romance. Something is happening in the underworld. Fae warriors are going missing one by one. Only the women are returned, each in a glass casket. A child clutched their breast. And then there are the whispers among the slaves, whispers of an evil that's been awoken. If the bargainer has any hope to save his people, he'll need the help of the siren he spurned long ago. Only his foe has a taste for exotic creatures, and Callie just happens to be one. Yeah, this is definitely going to be a very, 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 very spicy book. I can already tell. I'm super excited. I mean, what else is there to say besides a spicy book? I mean, who doesn't love spicy novels? Some risque novels, some romance, okay? And this is, I believe this is new. I did not look it up. Oh, it's not new. It's actually copyrighted in 2016. I wonder, I think this is a series. I'm not too sure. So honestly, I have yet to put this on my Goodreads account. I don't know why. I guess oh yeah, look, the Bargainer series. Duh, it's on the top of this book. Y'all, you guys, literally, I haven't done any research on this. I just saw it. I knew that it was spicy because of TikTok. I knew that it was on the book talk table, and I picked it up and I basically just read the back of it. And yeah, one thing I will say that's very satisfying for this book is how it feels. It's very just like flexible. I mean, I know soft covers are, but for some reason this is just extra. And I don't know, I'm really liking the feel of it. This matte cover, I don't know, it just gives me life. Yeah, I don't know. I might honestly have to do a reading vlog when I get to this, because I'm just dying to know how I'm just going to respond to this. I mean, I saw several TikToks how people responded to this, and I'm like, am I gonna respond the same way? I don't know, I'll keep y'all tuned. Man, you guys. Okay, so book number 7 is just straight on book spice, okay? So again, I'm just gonna say right now, the last book that I talked about and this one and the very last book, they were all on the book talk table. They're all, I believe, spicy. And I think this is actually even more spicier. This is Desperate Measures by Katie Robert. I think this is going to be spicier than Rhapsodic. I don't know. But this is a very, very small book. This came out, I think, a couple years ago in 2019. Honestly, I've never heard of this book before until I saw it at Barnes & Noble on the table. This is definitely a retelling of Aladdin with Jasmine and Jafar. Yeah, and this is a series, you guys. This is book number 1 in a series. And I must say, this must be very, very, very popular, because I tried ordering this online and it was sold out in Barnes & Noble. It was sold out in my local other bookstores. But I did go in person one day at Barnes & Noble when they had a huge restocking, and they only had, I'm not even kidding, just a couple of these books. Which, I mean, that must mean one thing. This must be a really, really good erotica, a smut book. This must be on the scale of spiciness. This has to be a 4 or 5, I'm for certain. So it has a very quick synopsis. I'm gonna read it to you guys. It says, "My savior or my ruin. One night and my entire life went up in flames. All because of him, Jafar. As my world burned down around me, he offered me a choice. Walk away with nothing but my freedom, or rise to his challenge and win my fortune back. I bargained. I lost. Now Jafar owns me, and even as my mind rails against the rules, my body loves the punishments he deals out when I break them. But a gilded cage is still a prison. I'll do anything to obtain my freedom, even betray the man I'm falling for." First of all, Jafar? Girl, really? I hope he is a very handsome character, because I just keep thinking of the Jafar in the actual Aladdin movie, and I'm just not seeing it. But okay, maybe Katie has some different retellings of what he looks like, and we'll see how Little Miss Thing deals with her punishments, her erotica punishments. I feel so weird saying that, but nonetheless, I mean, let's be real, I picked it up. Was I embarrassed at the checkout line? Possibly. Did I still go through with the purchase? I sure did. It's in my hands, and this is definitely going to be something I'm reading quite soon, because I feel like I'm just in the mood for everything. I feel like coming back from my wedding and not reading and not filming for you guys and just being on book content has me wanting and craving literally every type of novel. Like I really just need to just start filming myself just reading, and I'm sure y'all will enjoy it. I know I'm going to enjoy it. This, I mean, maybe this will have to be one of those books, you guys, that y'all definitely have to get my opinion on. I don't know. More to come. Let me know in the comment. I feel like there's going to be a lot of comments because I've been asking you guys for y'all's opinions on a lot of things, but this is quite serious. So let me know if you want me to maybe do a reading vlog or something like that. Maybe I could do a readathon and just constantly have a book in my hand. We'll see. Okay, guys, we have the last book. This is book number 8, and we have A Touch of Darkness by Scarlett St. Clair. Now, this one, again, on the book talk table, but I have seen a crap ton of TikToks about this book. I mean, everyone and their mom has literally been just raving about it. Like, people are saying, put this in your cart, go buy it, you must read it. Now, this came out, I think, in 2019. I don't know the month, but this is a relatively new book. Now, this is a retelling of Persephone and Hades, and this is a series. Now, there's a lot of books, and I think she just released another one in this series. I'm not too sure, but I do know, because of what's inside here, that there are some books in Persephone's POV and then some in Hades, which I absolutely love. I have never experienced that, where an author actually, well, maybe Midnight Sun. Okay, maybe the Twilight series, because Midnight Sun just came out, and that was in Edward's point of view. So I guess I have experienced that, but nothing to the extent of what Scarlett has done. So let me read you the synopsis. Oh wait, before I get into that, yes, this is a retelling, obviously. This is smut. It's on the spice radar. Where it falls on the spice radar for me, I have no idea. I feel like this is going to be like easily a 4. I just have that feeling, a gut feeling, that that's what it's going to be. A Touch of Darkness. Persephone is the goddess of spring by title only. The truth is, since she was a little girl, flowers have shriveled at her touch. After moving to New Athens, she hopes to lead an unassuming life disguised as a mortal journalist. Hades, god of the dead, has built a gambling empire in the mortal world, and his favorite bets are rumored to be impossible. After a chance encounter with Hades, Persephone finds herself in a contract with the god of the dead, and the terms are impossible. Persephone must create life in the underworld or lose her freedom forever. The bet does more than expose Persephone's failures as a goddess, however. As she struggles to sow the seeds of her freedom, love for the god of the dead grows, and it's forbidden. You guys, we love to see it. First of all, I will admit that in Hercules, that Hades specifically, I fell in love with him. As a child and as an adult, maybe, I mean, I know that obviously probably has some issues with that, but let's be real, like, it's Hades, you guys. I mean, he's one of my favorite Greek gods. Now I know I said I don't read a lot of Greek mythology, but I absolutely loved having those classes in school, and I just feel like this is going to be a really amazing book, you guys. I mean, regardless of the smut that we're going to have in it, I just feel like the storylines are going to be amazing. I mean, the fact that she has so many books just to let alone in the series, and I think she has other series, so like, I don't know, Scarlett, I may fall in love with your writing, and you have so many books out there. I mean, I might have to read all of them, you guys. Like, oh my gosh, this is going to be absolutely insane. But that concludes this book haul. I hope you really enjoyed it. I mean, I have a crap ton of books, you guys, and they're all in different genres, which, like I said before, coming back from my wedding, I am just craving every single type of book, and I cannot wait to get started on these. Like, wow. I mean, talk about having the perfect book haul, where I just have a huge mixture of all sorts of books, of all sorts of walks of life, different universes. We have thrillers, we have murder, we have smut content. I mean, geez Louise, I think I really just outdid this. I mean, pat on my back. But anyways, nonetheless, I really hope that you enjoyed this haul. Of course, there are going to be more hauls in the future. There's going to be more content. I am so glad that you stuck around in this video. I feel like I talked a crap ton, but I feel like I gave y'all a lot of just helpful information and books that you could just need, like, you just need to read. If you're in a reading slump, I highly recommend one of these books. I mean, it's bound to get you out of it, and I hope you're just excited as I am. Of course, I know I said leave me a bunch of comments before, but please leave me a comment on what you plan on reading next, what are you currently reading, and let me know what your thoughts are, if any, on any of these books that I just mentioned. But with that, guys, I hope you're having a great day wherever you are. I hope that you are enjoying a smutty, spicy book. Bye, guys.